So I want to talk a little bit about finances, because this is what seems to concern some in our community. I want to be clear. FDA, as part of their ongoing responsibility, has to review every project through financial auditors, independent consultants. They set aside large portions of money in their budget to do this. Not just in looking at Honolulu, but every city that wants to do rail transit has to go through this exercise. Okay? So Booz Allen Hamilton, Jacobs Engineering, Porter and Associates have all looked at our plan. Yes, they've raised issues. Yes, they see challenges. But I need to tell you, my staff knows that we need to provide answers. We need to verify what we are putting down on paper, because we don't want anything at the end of the day to come back and say, you missed this, you missed that, what have you. And I review every one of those applications that go forward, or reviews that come forward, or the questions that are asked. I personally see that. I have other sets of eyes in my administration that look at everything that goes before them. I think this is why they recognize that this is a relationship that is based on a mayor who doesn't hesitate to jump on a plane and go to San Francisco and meet with the regional folks there, or in Washington, D.C. I can tell you, every time I'm in Washington, D.C., I'm calling upon the FTA, every time, because I want them to know of our interests, and I want them to know that I recognize the situation with the economy. There are business people in this audience that know these things. You put out a financial plan. The economy, though, sometimes dictates that you need to amend your plan. You need to change your plan. You need to revise your plan. And the FTA recognizes this. So please don't be alarmed when they put out questions or statements that says that we need to look at this a little further. We'd like the city to strengthen this. Okay? The good news is that that's what we're doing every step along the way. Now, we also wanted to see that we had an independent group of local business leaders also look at our plan. Straight shooters, those who have a vested interest. Because it's one thing to say, well, maybe some of those folks live on the mainland, so they're going to just write what they're going to write, what have you. You hear that kind of talk all the time. But if a local group of business look at it, they live here, they pay taxes, they raise their families, I can assure you, like me, they don't want to see us undertake a project that's going to put this city or state in financial bankruptcy. And I've always told you, at the end of the day, I don't want to go down as the tallest mayor Honolulu's ever had, or the singingest mayor Honolulu's ever had, or the mayor that squandered billions of dollars for a project that went nowhere. Okay? I want this to be a project that culminated in everybody pulling together to put the people's train forward. So we welcome this review here. It was done through business leaders of the Hawaii Business Roundtable, and one of those individuals is going to be talking to you shortly of the things that they looked in. But at the end of the day, they called it sound and conservatively prepared. Those conservative projections by our administration has led us to believe that we are basically collected 99.5% of what we need for this project as of this point. So we're not facing a shortfall at all. So once again, don't be concerned about revenues going up, revenues going down. Some months is a good month, some months are bad months. We are on target, 99.5%. Now, the other thing that we've taken advantage of, and I learned this from the days that I worked for Doc Byers at C. Brewer, you always take advantage of changing market conditions, and you need to seize the moment. So, recognizing that it's a down economy, recognizing that people are out of work, recognizing that there are hungry contractors out there that want to go to work and put people to work, we put out our first RFP, and it came in at $90 million less than we had budgeted. Recognizing the good news there, boom, I went out with the second RFP, because I expect there will be also savings as a result of that. All of this is applied to the budget. That's why it changes. So a letter that you get in October, a letter that you get in August, does not reflect what is happening today. And that's why the most recent statements of our financial plan came out on February 2nd through Peter Rogoff and U.S. Secretary Ray LaHood, when they saw the current information at hand of our project, which is why it continues to move forward. The other thing that I've mentioned in the past, I'll just say it in passing, that we are required to have a contingency that we set aside for this. There's over $1 billion in contingency that we have set aside to take into account changing conditions in the economy, shortfalls, what have you. That's there, okay? Like any good business person, though, we're not going to draw upon that now. We don't have to, but it is there. So do not be alarmed by those who say that the bus service is going to be compromised. It will not be compromised. There are ways in which we can enhance, expand, and ensure that the bus service will be part of what I call an integrated multimodal system. You see, that's what's missing here in Honolulu, on Oahu. You get up in the morning, it's either the car or the bus or maybe the bike. I want the train to be part of that. I want you to plan your days, plan your evenings by saying, should I take the bus now, get to the station, catch the train, get off the train, take a bike, because I want to have bike stations at every train station so that you can bike like they do in other cities, and then reverse that trend in the afternoon. You know, this is what we're missing. We're missing choices, and that's what I want to provide for the 12th largest municipality in the United States, to have an integrated multimodal system that we can all participate in and obviously benefit from. Okay, next. Let me talk about the EIS. Yes, it's true that the final EIS has not hit the governor's desk. But I also want to stress, despite the fact that the federal government has not released the final EIS so that it can hit the governor's desk, they already went out on a limb and say they don't see anything getting in the way to preclude a final full grant agreement that's going to give us $1.5 billion, or that this year they're prepared to give us $55 million on top of the $65 that we've already gotten for rail. So here's the process and how it stands now. The draft EIS is already before the state government through the Office of Environmental Quality Control. 13 state agencies have had an opportunity in the past couple of years to opine, provide suggestions, recommendations, revisions, what have you. That's an ongoing process, and we respect that process. And we've been working collaboratively with 13 state agencies, and most importantly, the FTA knows there's been local dialogue. So this thing is not a well-kept secret hidden somewhere in the bowels of City Hall where no one is looking at this. They are looking at it. So we don't expect the final EIS to change substantially, which is why last year we submitted the draft EIS to the OEQC. The OEQC in turn gave it to the governor in December of 2009. So she has before her a draft EIS that's not going to change substantially. As the managing director said earlier, there's a couple of federal agencies who came forward with some issues that they had, and that's part of the process, whether they do it in 2007, 2008, or 2009. We respect that. We've basically resolved one of those federal agencies' concerns, and we're still working with the other federal agency, and they know of our desire for an expeditious review, because we need to get this project to us. And I think one of the best things that happened was the announcement again of FTA of their desire to sign a full funding grant agreement. So everybody is working hard, fast and furious, but making sure we cross the T's, dot the I's, so that we can get this to the governor for her review, acceptance, approval, what have you. Once she receives it, there's a minimum of a 30-day federal agency review period with the governor's acceptance, and then they'll issue what is called a ROD, or Record of Decision, completing the federal environmental requirement, and that will enable us to break ground. Okay, I wish it were sooner. I wish it were here. But, you know, in this game, you got to learn to be patient, but you got to be committed. You've got to be strong. And you got to stand tall in the saddle to be able to take the slings and arrows, whatever comes your way, to make sure that this project ultimately will succeed.